someday soon we kissed and clung together. Then tomorrow was another day. The morning found me miles away with still a million things to say. Dims the sky above, recalling thrills of our love. There's one thing I'm certain of, return I will.
Hi friends in Brazil and in other parts of the world. My name is William Owen, and since 1976, I've been living in San Francisco, California, on the west coast of the United States. Although I was born and raised on the east coast of the U.S., I never acquired much of the several regional accents from that part of my country. So I'd say that my pronunciation of American English is reasonably neutral. So why am I making this video? As a frequent traveler to Brazil, now totaling 14 visits since my first trip in 1999, I was asked by a Mexican-American friend and Portuguese language classmate of mine who lives in Rio de Janeiro and whose Brazilian partner is studying English there to provide my impressions of Brazil. My favorite city in Brazil is still Rio de Janeiro. My traveling companions and I include a week or more in the Cidade Maravilhosa on practically all our trip itineraries. I've taken Portuguese language classes twice at a school in Ipanema for 1 week and once in a school in Copacabana for 5 weeks. The physical beauty of Rio is simply stunning, as are the people who live there, the cariocas. In US terms, Rio reminds me of a cross between San Francisco, with its natural beauty built on hills beside a bay, and Miami, with its vibrant beach scene. I've had the opportunity to be in Rio during two of its most important holidays, Réveillon, or New Year's Eve, and Carnival. My friends and I even had the privilege of marching in the Sambódromo with a samba school, Paraíso do Tuiuti, that won second place in the 2018 competition on the Marquês de Sapucaí. I've also visited São Paulo and admire its culture, restaurants, and busy urban lifestyle. As an analogy to places in the U.S., São Paulo reminds me of a mixture of New York City and Chicago with their urban hustle and bustle. My friends and I consider Salvador da Bahia to be a special city because of its place in Brazilian history, music, dance, cuisine, martial arts, and the experience of Black Brazilians. We usually stay at a posada, a bed and breakfast, near the historic Pelourinho district. On our visits there, we have often tried to include Tuesday night as part of our itinerary when the Pelourinho offers a free evening outdoor celebration of music, dance, food, and capoeira on many of its hilly cobblestone streets. Two locations in Brazil that stand out in my memory for their amazing display of nature and our environment are the Amazon, where I stayed at a lodging built in a treehouse, and Foz do Iguaçu, where I was fortunate to be able to stay in the Hotel das Cataratas, where you can appreciate the power and size of the waterfalls the minute you step out of the hotel's entryway onto the veranda in front of the hotel. There's not enough time to go into detail about the other incredible places we visited in Brazil, but they include Búzios, Paraty, Petrópolis, Belo Horizonte, Ouro Preto, Parque Inhotim, São Lourenço in the state of Minas Gerais, Brasília, Natal, Curitiba, Mojeches, and Florianópolis. Truth be told, my Brazilian friends tell me that I've been to more locations in Brazil than most of them have had an opportunity to visit. As far as changes go, over time since our first visit to Rio de Janeiro in 1999, the increasing concern for personal safety stands out as our greatest impression, particularly in the large Brazilian cities. My traveling companions and I try to, quote unquote, dress down and not display valuables like electronics. Fortunately, we have not experienced any serious incidents or crime, although all three of us have had our debit cards cloned in Rio. As LGBT Americans, we are very concerned about the political future of Brazil. Recent reports of unprovoked attacks on LGBT Brazilians, on Brazilian women, and on racial minority Brazilians are very disturbing to us. In fact, we have planned a 6-week long trip to Brazil in February and March 2019. That said, we will be following the Brazilian news reports and the advisories of the US State Department very closely to determine whether we should cancel that trip. We hope that step will not be necessary. To end this video on a high note, my friends and I have enjoyed our many trips to Brazil immensely. The warmth and generosity of the Brazilians we have met have been our inspiration to return again and again. We sincerely hope from the bottom of our hearts that we will be able to continue to return to experience the physical beauty of Brazil and its people.
Someday soon we kiss and clung together. Then tomorrow was another day. The morning found me miles away with still a million things to say. Sky above, recalling thrills of our love. There's one thing I'm certain of, return I will.